Good evening, parents. Today we are going to look at an instructional text. What the child must know is that an instructional text is a non-fiction text that gives step-by-step instructions on how to make or do something. For example, a recipe. Now, they usually follow a specific format. So you have a step 1, step 2, step 3, and step 4. Now, the title of an instructional text will tell us how to do something, so it will often contain the word how. So the text will also the title of the instructional text will always start with how. How to bake a cake or how to make a pizza. Then in the instructional text we'll find the materials which we'll need to make something. For example, all the materials like the flour and the milk to make a cake. Then you will also find the instructions, and the instructions show you the sequence in which you will do or bake this cake. Then we have the imperatives. Now the imperatives are used to explain. For example, say to tell them, turn switch on the oven, or switch off the oven, or turn the oven to 180 degrees, or turn the oven to 120 degrees. Those are the imperatives. Then you also find diagrams. And the diagrams have labels, and they always include certain instructions to help the reader visualize the thing he is going to prepare. Okay, now for today, you are going to read an instructional text. And the instructional text is how to make a simple rain gauge, right? And you will see the first one say, they show us that the first one, what you will need, right? It tells us what you will need, okay? Then we have the instructions, then we have the steps up to step 5. So there are 5 steps how to make a simple rain gauge. See there? It starts with the word how. How to bake a cake, right? And this is what you will need to make the rain gauge. Then these are instructions and the other 5 steps. So what's going to happen is now you as a parent is going to read how to make a rain gauge to a child. You will read it 3 times, and while you are reading it the third time, then the child must answer the questions on page 104. They must answer number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. I repeat. After you have read the instructional text to your child, they must then take out their books and answer the questions on page 104, number 1 to number 10. Here on page 104, you will see a picture of a rain gorge. Then you must explain to the child that a rain gorge is used to measure rainfall. I thank you.